So the news caught you by surprise a little bit.
Yeah, very much by surprise. I honestly, in my heart, felt that Manu was going to come back and play. I thought of all the last 5 years, last year was one of his best. He wasn't besieged by injuries. Pop did a great job resting him. He won 3 or 4 games for us down the stretch single-handedly. And I just thought that, the competitor that he is, he was going to come back for one more. Marco Bellinelli, his brother-in-arms, was going to be there with him. And, my instinct told me that he was going to be here.
When it comes to Manu, there's two different questions you got to ask is, where does he rank all-time among Spurs greats? And then there's a different one, where is he all-time among most beloved Spurs? Start with that second one first. Is there any question that he's the most beloved Spur?
I think he easily could be the most beloved Spur. Because, I mean, the fans, they can see what type of player he is. He never cheated them. You knew that if you brought your family to the game, you could bring your kids, your mother-in-law, your mom, your dad, whoever, and you knew that if Manu was on the court, that he wasn't going to take that night off. He was going to compete and he was going to play hard. And you can't say that for everybody else. And so he never cheated the fans, he never cheated the game. He always played as hard as he possibly could, even in pickup games, even in exhibition season. Whenever Manu Ginobili was on the court, he played as hard and he competed as hard as he possibly could. And so that's just an endearing trait that I think a lot of fans obviously saw. But also away from the court, the fact that he could speak to the Hispanic community here as well and bring them into it. And he was a very considerate person. He was a very caring, considerate person. He signs autographs. He gets it. He understands that the fans are really the lifeblood of the league and especially a small market team. And, not everybody gets that. Manu's a very cerebral person. He's a pensive person. He thinks a lot and he's smart, and I think a lot of people picked up on that.
Sean Elliott's best attempt at summing up Manu Ginobili's legacy is?
That's a tough one, Hector.
Yeah.
I think he's been the most well-rounded Spur that we've ever had, besides being obviously one of the greatest Spurs players that we've ever had. To me, he's one of the most well-rounded. Because I've had an opportunity to be around Manu away from the game, after games, on the road and team dinners or on the airplane, and see how he treats everybody, everybody on the team, how he treats the media, guys in the back that, sometimes players walk by guys and don't pay attention to them, or, players, they don't know who all the radio guys or the TV guys are. Sometimes players just don't take the time to understand everybody in the organization, and Manu always did that. And he was kind and generous with his time to a fault. I mean, he really was. And I get emotional talking about Manu,
You're watching Sports Tonight, San Antonio's only nightly 30-minute sportscast with exclusive sports coverage you won't find anywhere else.